بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is the first question and asked to fill the MAC table of the switch, assuming that you start with a blank MAC table. So the MAC table is empty. And then you're supposed to process the MAC table and the action that the switch will take as a result of each of these four events. So I listed here four different events. And you are requested to fill the MAC table, assuming it's initially empty, and specify the action. And the action for the host is either to unicast on a specific port or flood to all active ports. These are the possible actions. Okay? So after each of these events, what would be the MAC table and what would be the action that the switch will take, assuming that these steps are accumulative. Accumulative means that this step, okay, is affected by this step. Okay? So this step takes into consideration the MAC table after performing this step. That's what that means. Accumulative معناه إيه؟ It accumulates every time. Okay? So I'll give you a few seconds So as we said before, if source 4444 wants to send to 1111, initially the MAC table is empty. So the switch will first look at the MAC table. Do I have any MAC do I have any port number for the MAC address 1111? The answer is obviously no. So what do I do? Flood to all active ports, طبعاً. Okay? But there's one thing I learned from here, which is MAC address 4, the MAC address 4444, I learned that it's connected to port A, port 9, because that's where the frame is coming from. Okay? So the switch will say, okay, I have a frame coming from port 9, okay? This frame has a MAC address of 4444, so the first thing I learned now is that 4444 is connected on port 9. But I don't have any port number for 1111. In that case, I will flood. Okay. Then, because this is accumulative, so in step 2, you should assume that this entry is already there. Okay. And now, 4444 wants to send to 2222. Do I have a port number for 2222? In the MAC table? No. So again, the action is the same. Okay? And from here, I can learn that 4444 is connected on port 9, which is already there, so I don't have to do anything. So here, now 3333 wants to send to 4444. Do I have 44 in the table? Yes. So I know where the port is, so I do a In that case, I do unicast to port 9. Okay? And from here, I learned something, which is port 6 has 3333. Okay? So these two will appear here. And now 33 wants to send to 1111. Do I have 1111 in the table? No. So it's flood to all. Okay? And from here I learned that 333 connects to port 6, which is already there, so I don't have to do anything. Mafhoum kalam?
How did we know that 333 is connected to 6?
Because that's where the frame is coming. In event C, 333 is sending a frame with a source MAC address 3333 and destination MAC address of 4444, right? So the switch will ask itself, do I have an entry for 4444 in the table? And the answer is yes, okay? So the destination address affects the action. Because I have an entry in the MAC table, I can just unicast. Because I know that port 9 is where 4444 is, right? Because it's already in the table. And I know Because the frame is coming from port 6, that port 6 has 3333, which exists as a source MAC address in the frame. فقلنا الفريم, sorry, the switch reads the source MAC address and the destination MAC address. The destination MAC address affects the action. The source MAC address tells me where this frame came from. So I can learn that this source is connected to that port. Okay? طيب. Jumping back all the way to chapter 7, we have a flow control question where we have A and B, and knowing that host A has a file of 500 bytes, okay, starting from initial sequence number of 250. As we said before, sequence number should not start from zero, it starts from non-zero. طيب. The segment size is 100. So how many segments do I have at A?
Five.
I have 500. Each segment is 100. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B has a window size of 300 bytes. Okay? So A can send up to 300 bytes without waiting for any feedback or any response from B. طيب. Here, بقى, show the sequence number and acknowledgement number and كذا, knowing that the acknowledgement number 750 was lost one time. But what we have discussed in the lecture before was the fact that some of the segments or one of the segments has been lost. Here, the acknowledgement is lost. Okay? So we need to process this when the acknowledgement with an acknowledgement number 750 has been lost. So first, A will send one segment. This segment has a size of 100 bytes. What is the sequence number here? Huh? 250. Starting from 250. Right? Can it send another segment? Yes. So it will send another segment. This one will have a sequence number of 350. Right? There's no acknowledgement number here because these segments do not have to acknowledge anything. Right? I don't have to put any acknowledgement here. And I can send the third one because the window size is 300. Okay, I send 200, so I can send the third segment. This one will have a sequence number of 450. I cannot send anything else until I receive a acknowledgement from B. So hopefully B will send me back some acknowledgement. The sequence number, I did not give it to you. And as we said before, sequence number is mandatory. So you can put anything here, anything. Doesn't matter. Even if you don't put it, we'll let it go. مش مشكلة. بس يعني, you should know that for correctness, every segment should have a sequence number. The most important one here is the acknowledgement number. What is the acknowledgement number here? 750. As I said before, in order to get the acknowledgement number here, imagine that you are sending another segment and the sequence number for the next segment will be the acknowledgement number here. So 550. Okay? So this is 550. Right? This means that up to 449 I have received correctly. Send me 550. That's what the acknowledgement number means. واضح? Okay. So, I sent 550. Can I send another one? Yes, I can send another one, which has 650. Okay. Can I send another one? Well, theoretically, yes. But do I have any more?
No.
I have only five segments, right? I finished sending all of them. Okay. So, I don't have anything else to send. Can I assume that here the answer is done? No, of course, because TCP is reliable. So you have to make sure that you receive the acknowledgement for you have for what whatever you have sent. So you have to make sure that you receive a positive acknowledgement. Okay? So we will have to wait. So B will send back some acknowledgement. What is the acknowledgement number here? This is 1001. This is 750. Yes. Go back to the question. Acknowledgement number 750 has been lost. إيه بقى العمل هنا؟ When?
Wait.
Huh? So this is lost. I did not receive it. Okay. Can I wait for it forever?
No.
Okay. So, what is the event that will happen here? Resend when? Times out, بالضبط كده. This is what we have discussed in chapter 3. And I mentioned that once you start any of these segments, by the way, you have to start a timer. Because you cannot wait forever. Okay? So the acknowledgement has to be sent within a time frame. If it did not come within a time frame, you assume that something wrong has happened. Okay? So now the question is, we timed out. We cannot wait forever. Logical. We timed out. Okay? And now we have to resend. Resend what, ba? We have to resend from the last step where we have received positive acknowledgement. Right? Which is 550. Okay? Can we send 650? Yes? Okay? Can we send any more? We don't have anything else to send. So we have to wait again for acknowledgement. There is, of course, implicitly here, there is some timeout, of course. And hopefully, in the next time, this acknowledgement of 750 is received. Because I told you in the question, 750 was lost one time. Okay? So in the next time, hopefully it will arrive successfully. So here it arrived successfully. Once it has arrived, I assume that خلاص, the file has been delivered correctly. And here the answer is done. So do not again assume there is connection establishment. Many cases, yani, students are a little bit confused. So they try to answer something not in the question. You assume that connection establishment, connection termination. I did not talk about this. Same thing in the previous question about the switch. They assume that there is a feedback coming from the destination to the sender. Did I tell you anything about this? فيعني, pay attention to the question and try to focus on what the question is asking for. Answer based on the question only.
Okay.
750.
Yeah, the sequence
here. I was asked the same question in the previous book. That's a good question, by the way. There has to be a sequence number here. If you put it 1002, it's correct. Okay, if you put it 1001, it's also correct. That depends on whether B realizes that the first acknowledgement has been lost by A or not. Okay, usually acknowledgement itself is not reliable. Which means that I do not have to receive acknowledgement for the acknowledgement. So, which means that implicitly all the acknowledgements are incrementally. So the correct thing is 1002. If you put it 1001, I will let it. If you don't put it, خلص, I will accept it. No problem. Okay. But for correctness, again, that's the correct thing. Any questions? Okay. طبعا we cannot ignore يعني subnetting. It's a good chunk of the course. So this question is asking you to subnet this network in two steps using VLSM. So in that case, we use VLSM. So for us, I don't want you to get scared when you see the word VLSM. As we said, VLSM is nothing but doing subnetting more than one time, yes. And luckily, in the lab, they told me that we leave it up to the student to design the steps in whatever way she sees appropriate. But in the exam, I want to be crystal clear. I want to, because confusion is already there and I don't want to increase it even more. So I try to be very specific. So I told you, here are the steps. Step one, we do one step of subnetting, which will supply minimum number of subnets. So first of all, remember, for these types of questions, by the way, I don't expect to find numbers and that's it. If you put numbers without showing how you came up with these numbers, there's no way for me to verify that you have come up with these numbers based on calculations. Okay? So in that case, excuse me, I have to deduct some grades. I need to see some calculations underneath here. I need to see how you came up with these numbers. So the address is 172.16.0.0. So what is the prefix here? This is class A. B, so this is slash A. 16. Okay, so I don't have to give you the network mask or the prefix in that case, because it's class B. Type. So in step one, as I said, we need to supply the minimum number of subnets, but such that we will allow for a growth of 50%. So many of the problems that we have gone through in the assignment and in the course, we have done something like that. So we need to focus on the subnets. So basically, class B slash 16. So basically, we put the address 172.16. That's fixed. Halas, we know that. And now we have 16 bits divided into 2 bytes, right? And we have some boundary we need to put for the subnet, right? This boundary can move back and forth. So the decisive part of the question that allows us to calculate this is when it says minimum number of subnets, such that we provide a growth of 50%. So what is the number of subnets here? Not exactly. Seven. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. واضح? So we have 7. With the growth, 50%. So in step one, current number of subnets is 6, 7, sorry. After growth, it becomes 11. Okay? So 11, we need how many bits do we need now? 4. معناها here, this is the subnet 1, subnet for step 1. Okay? And it's 4 bits. So now we can take these 4 bits, we can set it to all the different combinations, starting from all zeros to all ones, to come up with how many subnets in total? 16. All these 16 subnets, they are equally sized. So all of them are equally sized, and each of them will have how many host addresses? 2 to the power 12, bravo Ali. 2 to the power 12 minus 2 host addresses, right? They are equally sized, because this is after subnetting in step one, The subnets will look like this. So the first one, it will be 172.16.0.0/20. The next one, 172.16.1. It's 0001 and then 40. It will be 16.0/20. And then the other one, 32.0/20, 48.0/20, and you keep doing that 16 times. 16 different subnets. Which means that if we represent this using the cake graph, so we have a cake of which is actually divided into 16 different subnets. All of them are equally sized. Each one of them will have 2^12 different host addresses. Okay? So we take 7 of these, we assign to the 7 different subnets, okay? And all the rest is for future growth. So that's what subnetting does, but what VLSM tries to solve now is that if we go back to the question, in step 2, to save address space, the scheme will resubnet the second subnet from step 1, okay? Will resubnet it such that to accommodate the serial connections between the routers. For these serial connections between the routers, how many host addresses do we need?
Two for each,
صح? قلنا دائما الـ one connections, we need 2 host addresses, and that's why the subnet or the prefix will be a slash a
30,
right? So, so to provide the minimum number of hosts per subnet, we need to divide which one by? We need to divide the second one. Okay? So in step 2, so we finish step 1. So in step 2, we take this one slash 20, and then we divide it into slash A, 30 subnets. So here the number of subnets from slash 20 to slash 30, how many subnets do we have? To the power 10. يبقى كأني this is the first one. So the second one, this second slice, we have taken it and then we have divided it into 24, 2^10 different subnets. Okay? طيب. But this means that نعملها بالأزرق بقى. From this is slash 20. So from 20 all the way to 30, this is by the subnet for step 2. Okay? And we have done that for the second subnet from step 1, layer 16.16.0. Okay? So here, the number of subnets in step 2 is 1024. So the first one is again, so here the subnets will be by A. So the subnets will be 172.16.16.0/30, 172.16.16/A. .4/30, .8/30, 12/30, and so on. Yeah, four different addresses. And you keep doing that, 1024 different subnets. Okay? So these are the calculations that we have to do. This is like on scratch paper, this is our scratch paper. We have to do it inside the answer sheet. Okay? Or in the back or whatever. So that's our calculations. So now we can easily go back to the question and answer these numbers very easily. So what are the two custom subnet masks used in step one and step two? So in step one, the prefix was /20, in step two was /30. So /20, طبعاً, this is the prefix length. The question is asking for subnet mask. Okay? So we have to put it in dotted decimal notation. That's it. So it's 255.255.240.0. This is for the first step. For the second step, which is /30, /30 is 255.255.255.252.
For the one,
mm-hmm. This is what the question is doing. It's saying, ما جبش من عندي. The question is saying, in step two, we take the second subnet, and then we resubnet it again. That's from the question. مش من عندي. طيب. What is the total number of subnets designed? Design. عشان يعني برضو. في بقى يعني someone's trying to be smart and say واضحة we have 7 after growth it will be 11 يعني لا أنا أقولك design what you have designed is 7 ولا 11 what we have designed is something else yet what you have designed from the two steps is that first you divide it into 16 and then you divide it one into 1024 so what is the total number about yeah The same يعني.
The sum and
the sum بالضبط. The sum from step one is. بس ناخد بالنا بقى. The from step one we have how many subnets? ليه مش 16؟ ما هو في slice of the cake we have already sliced it again. Once you slide it again, it does not exist as one slice anymore, right? We said that in class. Clear. Okay. So 15 from the first step, and then from the second step, 1024. Okay? So what is the subnet address of the network between A and C? Between A and C, clearly, it's a WAN connection. But all what the question is asking for is to take one address from the subnets in the next, in the second step, not in the first step. In the first step, It's valid for the LANs, the big LANs. In the second step, we have designed the network addresses or the subnetwork addresses for the WANs, the WAN connections. So you can select whatever. ماشي, let's say 172.16.16.0. مش مشكلة. بس this is /A50. And this is a WAN connection. From A to C router, this is a WAN connection. طيب. And this is a typical... question in the final tries to group from different chapters. Draw the logical topology. So I took you back to chapter 4 or 5. Okay? Based on the same topology that we have. So now we need to draw the logical topology of this network. طيب. In the logical topology, we know that routers will stay, and what we need to worry about is switches and hops. صح? So switches will be mapped in the logical topology as a logical bus, and hubs will group all of them into one entity. So we know that. It's a simple rule. So we need to know which one of them is switch, which one of them is hubs. Here, the assumption is that except router A, B, and C, طبعاً, which will stay, assume that the research section, this part, uses switch. All of the rest uses a hubs. Type. What is the what is the logical topology here? Type. Here we have the routers will stay the same. So this is router A, B, and C. Router B has three LANs. One of them has, which is for the research section, this will be mapped into logical bus, right? And this is for the research section, right? The other two for, this is for marketing. It's a hub, so it's grouped into one node. And the other one is for finance. This is for finance. This is for finance. And it's all, it also uses a hub. طبعاً هنا, the serial connection will stay the same. Okay, because it's logical and physical. And now we have the A router is connected to another LAN. And in this LAN, we have two hubs. We have two hubs. The two hubs will be grouped all into one, so it will be one big node kada for sales and management. Okay, so that's the logical topology.
It's two switches, not two buses.
Nam?
If it's switches, not two hubs.
La, if it's you mean like if these are two switches,
yeah.
The two switches will be one logical bus. Two switches will be one logical bus. Okay? Hello, that's a good idea for a question in the exam. Any questions? But this is a typical question in the final. We sometimes try to relate chapters together so that we make sure that the students they can relate topics together. They are not confined to one topic and they forget about the others. You see?